Ah. Yeah. Ha. Damn. Okay. Okay. Jesus. Boy, I'm about to smack the shit out of you.
Severed hand
attached to the Soul Eater.
Huh.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. No need to fight it, right?
No, we will fight it.
Why?
Because you are frightened of it.
Let me just go back and collect what I wanted.
I'm ready!
Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. This wasn't a chest.
Everything that goes on,
but
he ain't
saying
nothing.
Yeah, goddamn right.
You got the nigga that has his back towards the world saying something.
That stupid motherfucker don't know shit. Not a dumb fuck like you, brother. Too easy, bitch.
We did it! I can't believe it.
Believe it. You are stronger than you know.
Thank you, Father. Let's see if that's the alchemist ring.
Green ring. Dwarvish inscription.
The alchemist. But where's the rest of him?
Ashes, most likely.
The Soul Eater got him. I guess we should bring this back to Brock.
What does it say?
Sir.
The fuck?
His runes were written fast.
It spells out Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward was promised.
Jealous? You work so hard, my God. I wish I was you, man. Tell him, Mexican. Tell him.
Tell him what?
Tell him, Mexican. Tell him I'm a grown ass man. You got that guy upset, Mexican. Shit.
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside, and well, it must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Feruxi.
Looks pretty dope, but I don't know if I want it though.
I'll take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside for he groped.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pig lips. Supple.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
Make you something? What else?
Sucks I can't upgrade shit.
Nobody's twisting your arm.
Can I do that? I've collected everything there. Oh, no, I didn't.
Boy.
See if I could do something from there.
Got another story?
Very well. There was a horse. The horse sought vengeance upon his enemy, a stag. But he could not kill the stag alone. The horse met a man, a hunter, and made a deal. He took the man's bit and bridle and allowed him to ride in a saddle on his back. Together, they killed the stag, and the horse tasted victory. But the hunter would not release the horse, and made a slave of him.
So getting revenge cost him his freedom. Hope it was worth it.
It was not.
Seen a waterfall so big.
Fuck is that? remember. First to move, and I've seen that last time. Ocean.
Come and face me, God of Thunder!
Your challenges mean nothing to the God Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. At first we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south.
Nice!
Spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Let his story be a reminder. The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
Got another story?
One more. There was a tale of a frog. His pond had dried up, so the frog and his son left to find a new home. They found a well. The son saw the water and made to jump in, but the father stopped him. He saw the well was deep, and once inside, they would not be able to escape if the water dried up again. Wisely, they moved on.
That's it?
Yes.
That's really not a story. If the son jumped in, it would be a story.
Then he would be trapped and starve while the father watched helplessly.
See? That's a story. You want a beach here?
Boy.
Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Hey, Brock. You ever hear of a Dwarf King?
I suppose you're talking about Motsignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of here.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Motsignir's known for collecting all manner of killering creatures. Not sure who's looking after him, then. To work it is! What'll it be, Shorty? Oh, you make up your mind? Later, then.
Motherfucker. Oh, shit.
What happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyway.
Ready yourself!
I'm ready! Ha! The Dwarf King, bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No, I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused. What does it say?
Yes, sir. Veda Dal. It means hunting death. Great.